welcome to Dots FM. That's Nicky, I'm Les. This week we have got a special edition of Dots FM. This one is dealing with all things cigar box guitar related.
A roundup of our cigar box related gear.
We have just come back from a cigar box festival, so we'll be having a bit of a roundup on that one, filling you in.
And then we will finish off the show with showing you what we do with a cigar box guitar dot style.
So first up, we're going to have a look at my cigar box guitar, the one that I use all the time, and I'll tell you a little bit about it. This is my cigar box guitar, I call it number three. It was the third one that I built, and it's also got three strings. Two A notes, and what is that?
A D.
I can never remember. Which gives you that sort of power chord thing. It's got a Deltalux pickup on it, and it's built on a Camacho cigar box that a friend gave me. The neck is one of Chicken Bone John's necks, you know, Chicken Bone John being sort of the most prolific maker of cigar box guitars, well, I think he is. Correct me if I'm wrong. Now, this neck was built. It was square profile, and it was built to be played lap style, left-handed, which was a bit of a conundrum because when I got the white dots that you use for the fret markers are on the bottom, so I had to put my own on the top, and I made it a little bit round. I made this about 5 years ago, I think, 5 or 6 years ago, and it let me down a couple of times. Once at a festival in Wales, just got into the last number and the pickup dismantled itself. So I've got these knobs on here, I've disconnected these, they don't work anymore, volume and tone pots. But we decorated them with pretty skulls, didn't
we? Yes, we did.
So now I've just got this Deltalux pickup, and this is wired straight through, and it works a treat. Never lets me down yet. And that little thing on the end is a little voodoo doll that I found in a puddle, and I rescued him and stuck him on there. I've not much else to tell you about it, really.
It's got glitter on it.
Yeah, it's got glitter all over it.
You did request that.
I was joking. A bit like when I said, can you put some on my nail?
He wasn't joking.
Anyway. So that's my cigar box guitar, tuned to a, it is the scale length on it, it's probably shorter than a normal one. I think when I built it, I think I cocked it up and I ended up having to cut it and cut it. Subsequently, it's tuned to a instead of, more often than not, G's is where they seem to tune these things. But anyway, there you go. And we'll be playing some more music on this this weekend, won't we?
I've got to move now. I'm not going to demo this. Les is going to demo it because...
Oh, what is it?
It's the stomp box.
Oh, it's the stomp box.
So, Les very kindly made me this back in 2018. A homemade stomp box from a cigar box. And it's called Bigfoot 3. And he signed it and everything.
I sweated blood over that thing.
Yes, literally, he cut himself. It did have like a nice pretty design on it, apparently, originally. I never got to see that because he managed to get his blood all over it. So
yeah, well, the box was originally covered in paper.
Yeah.
And it was a nice sort of cigar box to look at, but then when I slashed my hand with a Stanley blade and the blood went all over it, I tried to wash the blood off, and then the paper got wet and left it off. But luckily enough, that was, there was nice...
I know, that's cool, isn't it?
I think that was the bottom, but it's now the top.
Ah, right, yes. It is top because it says top here. Although that doesn't mean that. That means top as in you stomp this front, way.
Yeah, because that's where I put the pickup.
Because of where the pickup is. And it's got these little corner pieces on because I've got a cajon in the same design. So he made it so that it would match. And then there's a bit of Sharpie around the corners because of that. He loves using a Sharpie. Les is going to demonstrate how this box...
Well, we'll just do a little bit of foot stomping. I mean, it does...
I mean, I can stomp, it's just I can't play the
It does one
guitar.
Thing good. Next up, we've got my 8-string guitar. We don't use it live. A little bit bulky, bit cumbersome, but it's good for sitting down tinkering with. Now, I'll tell you a little bit about it. It's made by Daddy Mojo. It says so on the sides. That must be his trademark. It's not a real cigar box as such. It's been made to look like a cigar box. If it is a cigar box, it's a it's got all the trimmings of a cigar box, but I suspect it's been built. Anyway, it's got a resonator, which is an aluminium cone, if you don't know what that is, and it's also got a pickup, so you can play it electrically. Or you can play it acoustically. It's got the standard 6 strings, then the first 2 strings and the second 2 strings are double up. Why? I have no idea. It just looked odd. We saw it for sale. We thought, oh, we should have that, so we went to buy it. And it's got a bit of a pedigree, hasn't it?
Well, there was a bit of a story about buying it because it was in London. So we actually drove down to London. I mean, we went overnight, didn't we? We did stay overnight, yeah, to go and actually pick up this guitar because we decided that we definitely needed to have it. But Bono and The Edge have looked at this guitar and we have the photographic evidence to prove it, which we will put in now. They have got another guitar in the foreground, but I think it is it Daddy Mojo who's in the background?
I think it's the builder, yes, I think
and
it's Gary Bill.
He's holding this very guitar, so we were like, ooh, Bono and The Edge have looked at it.
They may well have played it, we have not got proof of that, but it was in the presence of the great man. Mm-hmm.
You may think I'm the keys girl, but I do actually have a cigar box guitar, don't I?
Very nice one too.
Very nice one. This is a Chicken Bone John cigar box guitar. I bought it at the guitar show, which was in
Haydock.
Haydock, about 3 years ago. Still can't play it, but that's purely because I haven't practiced because I'm
too busy. Blame your teacher.
But when you did give me a lesson the other day, I was learning scales, which I now can't remember, so I can't even demo it. This is tuned the same as yours, but it was tuned differently, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was tuned to G.
And it's got a pickup on it, but you can play it like...
It has some acoustic properties to it, yeah.
And I also, at the same time, bought this slide, this glass slide, which... goes on my little finger, doesn't it?
That's right. That's yeah. Right, I wear it.
Yeah. I can't demo it because I can't play it. Maybe one
so, day. So who made the slide? Anyone?
I got it from Chicken Bone John.
Oh, you're going for
it? Yeah, I got it when we got the when
good
we got
sale,
the guitar.
Good sale for him.
I also got this red strap at the guitar show as well, and I decided it went well on this guitar, so... I claimed it back off your bass.
I will get around to showing you how to do it.
Yes, I am going to learn how to play. I was inspired by the festival that we've just been to, so we will be moving on to that. Oh, the other thing, the other reason I'm inspired by the cigar box guitar is because of this young lady, Samantha Fish. She plays cigar box guitar like a demon in pink stilettos, just uber cool. And we went to see her just before lockdown. It was one of the last gigs that we went to before lockdown at Gorilla in Manchester. It was a brilliant gig, and we got to meet her. We've got a photo, we'll put it up, and
she reset your camera.
She reset my iPhone settings so that it would take better selfies. So thanks, Samantha Fish, for that, because I still use them.
You saw Nikki with a ceramic slide, very nice it is too, but it's far too small for my fat fingers. Plus I'm a cheapskate, so I'll show you what gear I use to pick the strings and to slide up and down. First of all, this is my slide. It's a piece of copper tubing that was left behind by Alan the Builder, and I asked him to cut me a piece off, and judging by that's not straight edge, I'm going to start questioning his building ability. I wish I'd have known that before he built a kitchen for us. But anyway, so that's the slide, piece of copper tubing. I also use a ring slide, which goes on my little finger, and I use this for sliding that way up the strings as opposed to that way. And this is the end of an IKEA tap. Just a bit that screws on the end where the where the water comes out, and there was a little filter. And a kit, I found this actually while I was building a kitchen, and when I come to the put the tap on, it wasn't working properly. So I complained to IKEA, and they sent me a brand new £138 wonderful tap with a spray on. And then I realised that this thing I've been playing guitar with was the missing piece. I won't tell them if you don't. So then moving swiftly along, I've got this. This is also something I use when I'm not using the full slide. This is a bit of a spoon out of my grandmother's top drawer. And I bent it over and it goes on this finger, and it's like, it goes in the sort of the center portion of your finger. And so then you can fret strings. You can't with a fistful of pigs. So you can fret. It doesn't get in the way. But we'll a bit more on that. If you ever see us playing, come and have a look. So that's that bit. And then I use thumb pick. because I can't feel my thumb, which is just one of these. I've forgotten who makes these damn things. I like them though. So that's a thumb pick. I forget the name of that company. Oh, it doesn't matter. We'll find it. And I also use a finger pick. This is a bit more interesting, if you can see it. These, I found this inside an old banjo case. Somebody gave us an old 70-odd-year-old banjo or something, which wasn't much good. But inside the little pocket was some picks. And there was a couple of these in. And it says Dobro one, which is the old sort of resonator type guitar thing that country players use. And these picks are special because they bend around and then they curl up at the tip of the finger. I don't know, can you see that? Maybe not. You see curls up there?
Yeah, you can.
Normally they just curl around. And I do believe they've stopped making this particular pick because of something that was, some chemical that was, I think it was cyanide or something, was used in the manufacture of it. And apparently it was outlawed in about 1968. So if you do ever find any of these, and they'd sell for about $50 on them. On eBay, but I've got used some. I wouldn't use anything else, and when they're gone, I'll stop playing, which might please more people than I.
And how many times have you lost one of them?
Oh, well, quite a lot. I didn't lose them, I just mislay them. They sort of.
One was under the sofa for 6 months. What? We only found out when we rearranged the room.
Well, when it falls on the floor, you can't see the damn thing. It sort of blends in. Anyway, I've managed to keep them for a few years now, so. Anyway, so that's all my gear, thumb picks, finger picks, ring slide, end of an IKEA tap, and a piece of copper tubing from Alan the Builder. And as I've said on more than one occasion, I'm probably worth more a scrap.
So while we're doing a gear roundup, in addition to my Chicken Bone cigar box guitar, I also bought from his website this lovely case for my cigar box guitar. And this case has been absolutely invaluable. It does have a middle section where you can put all your picks and paraphernalia. But we took that out because instead of just using it for the cigar box guitar, which I mean, it does fit in there quite wonderfully, we found that all our synths fit in here. No matter what we are taking with us, computers, synths and stuff, everything just fits in perfect. So it's just a brilliant, brilliant case. Multi-purpose, I'd say. And, you know, it's got that grey tweed look. And, yeah, it's really good. Very handy.
Moving swiftly along, as we have been known to do, it's over to Nikki.
So last weekend, we went to a cigar box guitar festival called Box Stock. Organised by Chicken Bone John, and it was in Wolverhampton from Friday to Sunday. Well, Friday and Saturday night, and Saturday day, if that makes sense.
We just happened to still be there.
We happened to still be there. So were the Dust Brothers, because we saw them coming out of our hotel. There was live music on the Friday and Saturday night, and on the Saturday there was various trade stalls, open mics, sessions and stuff going on. So it was a really good, fun-packed weekend of all things cigar box.
Like-minded people enjoying each other's company.
Yeah.
And it was very nice. It was a great atmosphere.
It was, yeah. It had been postponed, I think, at least once, maybe twice, due to lockdown. So we finally made it there, which was great. And yeah, it was brilliant. So big thanks to Chicken Bone John for putting that on. We can't wait for the next one.
It was a good scene, wasn't it? I was quite impressed with the number of people I thought it was going to be three men and a dog. sometimes that happens. But
it was really good atmosphere. Yeah. So we've got some clips from the weekend on the Friday night. There was various artists playing, including Hollow Belly, his last ever gig. And although I've got a photo, which I'll put in.
Tell them what happened to your camera.
Literally, my phone ran out of battery. We've been travelling down that day and using Apple Maps to get down there. And
mine was flat as well.
Yours was flat, mine was flat. So we got no video footage, unfortunately.
I believe it was his last
Last gig, yeah.
I hope not, but yeah. Last summer, I don't know if I read that or something.
No, it's a, I think it was, yeah.
Was it Bill, was that?
I think it was, yeah.
Damn. Mm. Anyway, we wish you all the best in future, Mr. Hollowbelly.
So on the Saturday night, we saw Bobster, Kevin Brown and the Dust Brothers. And we do have some video footage from the Saturday, which we will show now. Smoke on the water, fire in the sky. Smoke on the water.
Doing well. Gotta get some rest, I'll sort you out, just slow down. Take it easy for a while. You wanna stay alive, change your lifestyle. Thank you.
hoping I would find that love that I was looking for, but I'm holding on to getting older. Hold up, hold up, my heart's like an arrow.
So if you are interested in Cigar Box Guitars, or you think you may be interested, check out, there's a Facebook page which is called UK Cigar Box Guitar. There's also a big American thing called Cigar Box Nation.
Website.
Just Google these things, you'll easily find them. And there you will find all kinds of plans on building your own instruments, people selling them. Everything you need to know. Normal business will be resumed on the next Dots FM when we combine the cigar box with our electronics. And if you're wondering what that's going to sound like, we'll leave you with a tune. This is the Blind Willie Johnson piece called Dark Was the Night, Cold Was the Ground. And until next time, bye-bye.
Bye.